Hello, my name is Katie and I'm one of your Blackpool and the Fylde College School Liaison Officers. And today I am joined by Mark, who is one of our senior tutors from our sports department. And today we're going to look a bit deeper into this curriculum area and hopefully answer any question that prospective sports students would like to know about Blackpool and the Fylde College. So hello, Mark.
Hi.
Thank you for joining me. How are you today?
I'm good, thank you, yeah.
Great. So obviously here at Blackpool and the Fylde College, all of our tutors are industry specialists from their subject field. So we'd like to know a bit about you, really. So can you tell us a bit about your background before you came to Blackpool and the Fylde College as a tutor?
Yeah, I was a professional footballer.
Wow.
I played for Bolton Wanderers. So I actually, at the age of 16, signed an apprenticeship for Bolton Wanderers.
Great.
Played there for 4 years, had a few loan moves. Moved to Ireland to play for Sligo Rovers, came back to Wycombe Wanderers, who were in the First Division. Got to semi-final of the FA Cup whilst I was playing for Wycombe. And then unfortunately got a bit of a knee injury, so I ended up playing at a few other clubs. Stevenage, Borough, I ended up playing for, but had to retire at the age of 30 with a knee injury. So that obviously led me to a second career choice. I went down the coaching route, worked at Blackpool Football Club for 3 years as the academy goalkeeping coach from the under-9s all the way up to the academy boys. And whilst doing that, I retrained, went to college, did my degree, then my teacher training, was lucky enough to get a job here whilst I was doing my teacher training. And I've been here ever since, so I've been here for the last 11 years.
Wow, that's an amazing career that you've had, definitely. It's really inspirational. So in terms of our sports curriculum area here then at Blackpool and the Fylde College, we offer a range of different sports courses. So we offer some level 2 and level 3 courses in generic sports, and we also offer our level 3 in fitness as well. So can you give our viewers a bit of information about those courses and just what they could expect to learn on those courses if they come and study with us?
Yep, so the level 2 is the progression to the level 3. So again, like you say, covering a number of general courses to build that knowledge base, ready for the higher level. So you look at anatomy and physiology, you'll look at sporting performance, so practical team sports. You'll look at the fitness side of it, nutrition side of it. And then you obviously progress, providing you pass all of the courses, you go on to the generic sport course, so you can go down the other pathway, which is the fitness side of it. In terms of the generic side of it, we've moved to a new qualification.
Okay.
So we're kind of looking at, there are a lot of coursework that goes with it, but two units now have to be exam based, which is the anatomy and physiology and the fitness testing programming side of things, looking at well-being as well. So those two courses carry examinations, which we tend to do in January. Hopefully you pass in January, but if not, there is a retake option in June as well. So it's not all doom and gloom if you is to fail in the January aspect, because we can resit them in June. And then we've got other coursework-based ones, such as your practical side of it, looking at sports nutrition, looking at the sporting industry as well. So what jobs you might be able to go into, looking at how that progresses through, and also looking at leadership in sport as well, to tailor towards lots of different career pathways.
Fantastic. Obviously, you mentioned there that we do have some exams now in our sports courses, but obviously our sport course is very practical as well.
Absolutely.
So as part of our sports kind of general course, what kind of team or kind of individual sports can students expect to kind of get that practical experience in and try out, really?
We try to cover as many as possible. So we'll look at obviously popular sports. So you've got your footballs, your rugbys, your netballs. So those popular sports. But we'll try and cater for other sports as well if we can. We'll look at badminton. We'll look at boxing if appropriate, if there's enough people interested. Also links into our enrichment program that we deliver as well. So on a Wednesday afternoon, hopefully when things get back to normal, we can get our sports teams up and running. So we have our football, we have basketball. So there's lots of different opportunities to take part in practical team sports, individual sports. We try to make lessons as interactive as possible. So if we was looking at risk assessments, then we wouldn't want to do that in the classroom. We want to physically get out, get to the sports hall, down to the sports pitch, having a look around. Same with the fitness testing aspects. Make them as practical based as possible and realistic to industry as possible as well.
That's great. Thank you for that. So much information about all of our courses and the different sports that students can obviously look forward to learning if they've not tried before at school. Yeah. So obviously we're sat in a gym here at Blackpool and the Fylde College. So yeah. Here at the college, we have a lot of sports facilities, which are mostly based at our Bispham campus. Yeah. So can you just tell our viewers about the different kind of facilities that we have here? Obviously this gym being one of them.
Yeah, we've got fantastic facilities here. So we've got, obviously, we're in Inspiration, which is the gym. This is used as part of the fitness elements as well. So if you was to do our fitness pathway, then you would be training to be a gym instructor. So you would be using these facilities here. We've got the sports hall as well, which we take part in a number of sporting activities. So again, we look at circuit training within there as well. So that would fit the fitness pathway as well. We've got the 3G AstroTurf pitch as well. So we consider that another classroom. So just because it's a sports pitch, it can be used for a variety of different things. So again, trying to make things as interactive as possible, but using the facilities that we've got available.
Definitely, and our kind of facilities as well, so the gym and the sports centre and the 3G pitches, they're all open to the public as well to use, aren't they?
Absolutely, yeah. And students as well can get their own membership at a discounted rate as well. And if they're members of the sports team as well, once they've gone through the induction process, as long as they remain part of the sports teams, then they can use the facilities for free.
It's great, that, isn't it? Imagine doing your studies and then just going to the gym afterwards. You don't even have to worry about travelling or things like that because you're already here.
Yeah.
So that's great. So as part of all of our courses here at Blackpool and the Fylde College, all of our students have the opportunity to undertake work placement. And obviously work placement is a part of all of our sport courses. So what sort of links to employers locally do we have that students can maybe expect to work alongside as part of their work placement?
We've got fantastic links. Work with Blackpool Community Trust. We work with AFC Fylde. We work with numerous gyms, local gyms. We've got ex-tutors here who have gone on into other professions as well. So we link into those contacts as well. So in terms of different career pathways, we can tailor most of our work experience to student need. So if they've got a particular pathway that they want to go down, if they wanted to be working analysis, for instance, then we can work with our local community providers and look at how we can get them into analysis. I've got contacts with other football clubs as well. So again, we can get people into there. We've got contacts all over the place. So if they wanted to tailor it specifically, then I'm sure we could provide that opportunity.
And obviously for people that may be looking into maybe sports coaching, do we have those links with local schools in the area to be able to go in and teach there?
Absolutely, yeah. In some of the courses as well, we use that as an assessment method. So going into a high school or a primary school, delivering our leadership sessions to a base. We've had schools come in as well to be able to deliver those facilities to as well, those sessions to as well. So yeah, we're very flexible in what we can do, but and we try to get out into the community as much as possible and make it realistic. So yes, there's a theory side of the courses. However, we try and put that theory into practice and make it as enjoyable and realistic to what it would be like in industry as possible.
Amazing. It's great that we have all those links with local employers, that students can really get that work placement that's meaningful, not just somewhere, you know, that's not going to provide any experience for them in that area that they're interested in. So you touched upon it a little bit there. So in terms of careers, yeah. What sort of careers can our sports and our fitness students kind of look forward to going into after they leave here?
There's a variety of different career pathways now. If you look at how sport is developing, if you look at how technology is now developing, analysis has become a major part of sport. So it's not just your community coach, it's not just your sports coach. There's the analysis route, there's scouting, there's looking at a variety of nutritionalists. So again, thinking about all the units that we do, all the units are picked to provide career opportunities. So if you wanted to be a fitness instructor, you can go down that path. If you want to be a community coach, if you want to analyse football, or you want to analyse rugby or netball, we've invested in some software called In Play Sport, online sport, which allows you to upload a video but then clip it. So you can look at the whole video, but if it could be a 30, 40 minute video, but we can clip it down to say 3 or 4 minutes, but we can make it specific as well. So in terms of the tagging that we can do, so if you can put your name in it, and every time you appear on it, you just click this button and it will clip that section for you.
Oh, wow.
So again, looking at how industry is evolving, looking at how technology is evolving, and trying to meet the needs of the jobs that are there now, but also that the jobs are going to be created in years to come in terms of how technology is advancing, because of the way it's progressed over the last 3 to 4 years, maybe 5 years, all different types of jobs are appearing, exciting jobs, things that maybe we haven't thought of yet, that by the time you finish your degree or your teacher training or whatever it is you go on to, there could be jobs out there that haven't been invented yet.
Fantastic. I think we are, as Blackpool and Fylde College, we have all of these high-tech equipment, we have all the high-tech facilities, and we obviously have our industry specialist tutors as well that students can look forward to working alongside. So thank you so much for joining me today, Mark.
No problem. It's been a pleasure.
Thanks, Mark.
Okay.
So if you'd like to find out any more information about our range of sport courses here at Blackpool and the Fylde College, then please check out our website at blackpool.ac.uk. You can also download our online prospectus from our website for information on all of our courses across Blackpool and the Fylde College. And of course, if you are interested in applying for any of our sport courses here at the college, then you can do this by checking out our website, finding your desired course, and by clicking the apply button. But for now, thank you so much for joining us, and goodbye.